finally bring more manufacturing of medical devices back into America. Those are great conservative wins. Nancy Pelosi wants to rip all that up. Y'all seen her. You know what she wants to do if she stays as Speaker. Is Nancy Pelosi going to be the Speaker of the House next year? When President Trump wins re-election, and again, this debate is going to be critical, because there were millions of people, about 8 million people who voted for President Trump in 2016, didn't show up in 2018. I can tell you this, I've been around with the president, the enthusiasm's never been higher. They're gonna be showing up, and I think in even larger numbers for President Trump in 2020 because of what he's done to deliver and what we wanna do working with him. And think about this, President Trump has not only talked about the things that he wants to do to lower health insurance costs, he's delivered for families. But we've been working in Congress. We actually had a bill come out of committee unanimously, every Republican and every Democrat, to lower drug costs. And Speaker Pelosi won't bring those bills to the floor. We'll surely bring them when we're in a Republican majority working with this president who would sign those bills into law. And just to give you an example, there's something right now called pay to delay, where drug companies, when a drug's about to go to the market for generic, you know a generic drug similar to the original drug, but a lot cheaper. Well, the drug company today can pay the generic company not to make the generic. That should be illegal. We had a bill to make that illegal. And Speaker Pelosi won't bring that package of bills to the floor. So just imagine, you today could be paying lower costs for drugs. President Trump wants to sign that bill and they won't bring it to the floor. We're going to turn that around. We're going to bring those kind of bills to the floor with the Republican majority working with President Trump to get those things done. Surprise billing? We've got a lot of medical doctors in Congress. It's hard to be a doctor today with Obamacare, so a lot of those doctors left the practice and ran for Congress. Most of them are Republicans, by the way. They want to work, and they've got really good ideas to lower health costs. They know the doctor-patient relationship is vital. They know that we don't want government control over health care because of what works great in this country. And I can tell you, I've gotten to see a lot of this, and so just a real good example of this, because health care is very personal to me. I would not be here today without the greatest healthcare system on the face of the planet. I'm truly not the one to take that away from you or anybody else. And we don't want to go to a European model. We don't want to go to a Canadian model. In Canada, less than half the drugs that are available here in the United States, life-saving drugs, less than half of those are available in Canada because they have government controls, price controls. Might sound good on the surface until you see it in practice. Tens of thousands of Canadians come to America to get life-saving treatment in healthcare. Do you see a lot of Americans going to Canada to get that same treatment? Because you'd have to wait in the same lines as thousands of other people. So I got to travel 2 weeks ago to New Hampshire with President Trump. And there was this great rally, 11,500 people that are going to be almost as loud as y'all when President Trump speaks on Saturday. But one of the guys I met there who was campaigning for President Trump had a sign that said, "I fled Canada." And I went over and I talked to him, and he's a big Trump supporter, and he said, "Socialized medicine ran me out of Canada because I don't want the government telling me what to do and controlling my health care." We're not going to let that happen. Are we going to let them turn us into a socialist nation?
No.
No way. When President Trump says America won't be a socialist nation, amazing how in a State of the Union we all stand up, I get physical therapy, I get to jump up and applaud that, and you're watching all the Democrats sitting down. President Trump talks about killing terrorists, and all the Democrats sit down. I mean, look, I hope it's not a partisan issue, but if killing terrorists becomes a partisan issue, put me in the party that's for killing the terrorists. And I applaud this president for his leadership. His leadership on so many issues, domestic policy, foreign policy, hottest economy in the world. Just look at yesterday and what he did, the leadership he took to address and tackle the coronavirus. Our next speaker in a little while is going to be the Vice President of the United States, Mike Pence. You cannot have a better person leading this effort, but it shows how serious the president is. They would put the vice president in charge, bringing the entire weight of the federal government to tackle this crisis like he's done with so many others. But let me tell you, as I get ready to leave and this next panel comes out to talk about healthcare, healthcare is only one example of what's at stake in this election and the sharp contrast between conservative principles and government control. They want to do it on every aspect. They're talking about raising your taxes, everybody's taxes, not just the millionaires and the billionaires, like the people on stage in the Democrat primary, but hardworking families who are benefiting from the low taxes that we put in place with Republican House and a Republican Senate and a Republican president who signed it into law lowering everybody's taxes. And look at how great it's working. It's working for everybody. We're not going to let them take that away, right? So when you think about this, government control, they want to take away your guns. Are we going to let them do that? No way. Are we going to let them take away our ability to drive whatever car we want? And if you want to put gasoline, if you want to put solar panel that runs your airplanes, they want to take away your airplanes. I mean, this is crazy what they're talking about. The Green New Deal, Medicare for all. It's about government control over individual freedom. And you know what? In 2020, individual freedom is going to win out. We will reelect Donald Trump as our president. We'll get a Republican House, we'll get a Republican Senate. The people are going to save this great nation. It's worth fighting for.
Thank
and
you.
I thank you for being in this fight with us. Thank you so much, my president. God bless you.